The question is, do I make them myself? And the answer is,
oh,
yes.
Ow.
That's the result of doing glass blowing by an amateur, somebody who's a physicist doing glass blowing. The answer is, I make the first Klein bottle. I make sort of number one. I work on the design, figuring out how the spline should look. Then I work with Adams and Chittenden, who are real glass blowers over here in Berkeley. And so they bend it, put on a glass lathe, and do cool things like you start with Pyrex, you torch it up, heat it up, blow on it, and inflate it till you get something that looks like this. And after you inflate it on the torch, oh man, I wish I had a glass lathe here so you could see hot glass. Trust me, it's hot, red hot glass. And then after you inflate it, you take a diamond saw, cut here, torch the base open, then you go to the glass lathe, take another half inch piece of Pyrex tubing, flare one end, bend it, cut it, put it in the glass lathe, weld it like this. I don't know if that's even visible. So, okay, so you weld it in like this, and you get, this is even noticeable. Ah, far out! And you get a torched in piece like this. Next step is cut here, pop open this hole, then go bend a piece gooseneck like this, and notice how you have to seal one end and keep this pressurized as you bend it, or else it'll kink around here. Cut here, weld it right there, bend it around like this, and there's your Klein bottle. Oh, and along the way you drop it on the floor, it breaks, it shatters, you pick up everything, you burn yourself, you know, the usual, it's glass blowing, it's hot glass.
Surface, and compare it with any other Klein bottle, then this one has the lowest possible energy. I thought, that is pretty cool, maybe that is number four. But again, you can obviously tell by looking at it that this thing seems to have some chirality again.